Hey everyone, Sanjay here from Contriver Podcast, and you're watching Conscience Show, episode number 25. So today we are going to talk about credit cards, the biggest vulnerability of your entire corporate life, people who work in 9-to-5 jobs. And let's get started, guys. Now, what the banks does is, they give you a golden offer called, sir, you have eligible for an international credit card. With this, you can purchase more than what you earn. It's somewhere around 10,000 that you can purchase. Your salary would be somewhere around 30,000 per month, but you can purchase 10,000 extra from this credit card. With this, you will be the king. That's what they tell you. But I'll tell you the truth. What happens? Let's say you get a credit card now. I don't have a credit card for sure. That's the reason I'm not showing you. So let's say you get a credit card, and what you do, once you buy that credit card, credit you with certain money. And then what happens? You keep that credit card saying that I don't want to use this for some dumb things. During month end, what do people do? The mall and your supermarkets, what do? They give you an offer called as end of season sale. What does that mean? That is nothing but a sale to use your credit card. I'll give you an example. What happens? One fine day, your neighbor, they tell you, we'll go for shopping. I want to purchase something, but you don't have to purchase anything. Because you can do window shopping. You promise yourself that you'll do window shopping. Once you get into that particular supermarket or you get into that particular mall, what happens? There's a desire that pops up on your mind. Just in case, if you feel like you want to purchase something, you take your credit card. In case if there is something that's too flashy for you, that you wanted to purchase from many days, you take your credit card. And once when you enter, you see too many flashy colors that is on that particular mall or in that particular supermarket. Okay, fine. Let me purchase this one thing so that I'll get one more thing. Buy one, get one offer. 50% offer, 70% offer, flat 25% offer. Let me tell you, those things that they are offering you is nothing but it's been stored in their particular inventory and has been never sold. Just because those things were never sold for a longer time period, they just give you certain offer saying end of season sale. And what do you guys do? You go purchase that. That looks really flashy. That looks really good. There's an offer buy one, get one free. You just go buy that. And you scratch your credit card. What happens then? You start working for the money that you never owned. You start working for the bank and the company that you are working on. Until you clear that particular debt, it's like you won't even buy anything else. What happens then? You also pay high interest on that credit card. So you don't have to purchase the new iPhone that has been launched, right? Your phone works good. Why do you have to purchase that? When you're purchasing something which looks too flashy, what happens? You're not just purchasing that particular commodity. You're purchasing that brand. Those things, you don't need that. But you are just tricked by the market of that marketing of that particular company. That product has been marketed to you. You don't need the new iPhone. You don't need the sneakers that Nike really launched in a new collection. You don't really need that. That is just for taking a picture, posting in Instagram. That doesn't fetch you money, guys. You just have to understand. Buying something, let's say you go buy a coffee in Starbucks. You're not really buying the coffee. You can prepare better coffee than Starbucks. But you're just buying the logo of the Starbucks. When you're buying a burger in McDonald's, you're buying those two golden arches. That is what looks so fancy in the social media, right? That is what you guys are buying. You can prepare a better burger for yourself in your home. But still, why do you do that? You feel like you want to show off. You want to show off with your friends. Even those people are doing the same. You're just an average of four people who you spend with. If your friends are dumb, kind of obvious that even you will be dumb. So, as I said, you're just an average of four people who you spend with. Who's the fifth person? Who's the fifth dumbest person? Obviously you. So when you're just spending things, if you want to buy a coffee, go buy a coffee somewhere else. Why do you need Starbucks? That's the biggest liability again. When you do that in the start of the month. What happens when you do, when you feel like having a coffee in Starbucks during the end of the month? You control yourself. You are the master of your own life, right? Why don't you control in the beginning when you have money? You say you can spend that money to create more assets, but you don't do that, right? That's the reason you're stuck in rat race. That's the beauty of your beautiful golden credit card, guys. You know, there are tons of product in market that you can only purchase if you have a credit card. The entire corporate world is a big chain that is surrounding you. You just have to break that chain and get out of that. That is how you become rich, or that is how you become financially literate. I'll end this video with the same quote that I have told you in the last video. If you haven't watched that, make sure you watch it. But the quote goes like this. This never changes. If you dug a hole where you stand, make sure you stop digging yourself. Make sure you stop digging that particular hole. You just have to get out of that hole. If you start using your credit card again, you're just digging a bigger hole. You just stay in the underground and you have no way to get out of it. Because your credit card interest, that is way more expensive than what you guys earn. And that's the biggest debt a bank can offer you. And the most important thing is there are products that are really exclusive for credit cards. Just like an iPhone in an online, or just like getting into McDonald's. If you use your credit card, they'll give you 5% offer. Sounds really weird, right? And that 5%, you'll save it and you pay some 7% interest for bank. Sounds really horrible. So that's the reason you're digging the hole even more deep where you can never get out of it. The only trick that really works like a charm to get out of this particular thing is take your credit card and break it. Trust me, no one's gonna scream at you. No one's gonna scold you, or no one's gonna fine you. It is for your goodwill. You can break that credit card and trust me, you can live a happy life out of it. So in our next video, let's start talking about another financial thing, about this financial literacy. And that is what I love to share with you guys. We'll see you in our next video. Thank you, guys.